model, it appears in the current issue of Mother Jones magazine. This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, the War and Peace Report, as we stay on the issue of water.
Yes, well, we turn now to another story about water. New evidence has emerged possibly linking natural gas drilling to groundwater contamination. ProPublica reports federal officials in Wyoming have found that at least three water wells contain chemicals used in the natural gas drilling process of hydraulic fracturing. The Wyoming study marks the first time the Environmental Protection Agency has undertaken its own water analysis in response to complaints of contamination in drilling areas. Residents in Pavilion, Wyoming have complained for years that their water wells turned sour and reeked of fuel vapors shortly after drilling took place nearby. ProPublica reports precise details about the nature and cause of the contamination have been difficult for scientists to collect, in part because the identity of the chemicals used by the gas industry for drilling and fracturing are protected as trade secrets.
Gas drilling companies such as Halliburton say the gas drilling technique known as hydraulic fracturing or fracking is safe. But opponents contend it pollutes groundwater with dangerous substances. Here in New York, many politicians and residents have expressed concern that natural gas drilling in upstate and in Pennsylvania could contaminate New York City's drinking water supplies. In a moment, we'll be joined by reporter Abrahm Lustgarten of ProPublica, who has been closely tracking the story. But first, we want to play an excerpt from a new documentary called Split a State by Deborah Anderson. The documentary examines the impact the oil and gas drilling boom has had in the Rocky Mountain West. This part deals with Garfield County, Colorado.
In 2004, some residents in Garfield County began to complain that they were getting sick as a result of the drilling activities in their neighborhoods. A young woman from Silt, Laura Amos, was one of the earliest and loudest voices.
As everyone in this room probably knows, my groundwater has been contaminated with methane, Williams Fork gas. There are a lot of people in this room with contamination and pollution issues. So who then is responsible to me for that loss of my welfare if it's not you, the gas commission?
If a well is drilled next to your residence or near your residence within the legal setbacks and there's a perceived or real impact on your property value, we don't address that.
In 2001, gas wells were drilled using the fracking technique a mere 500 feet from the Amos home. Underground, the drilling breached their water well, causing their drinking water to fill with gray sediment and fizz like soda pop. The Colorado Oil and Gas Conservation Commission tested the water well and found methane, but said it was safe. But they warned the Amoses to keep a window open so the methane gas wouldn't build up and cause an explosion in their home. The Amoses stopped drinking the water, but continued to bathe in it.
A young woman called me from Garfield County and said that she had developed a rare adrenal tumor, that she had had this incident with her well. That was the beginning. I mean, when she called, it just sent chills up and down my spine. She had been breastfeeding her daughter through the period when they were using the water that they were told was safe. She was bathing her baby in the water in their home. They were breathing the stuff that was coming into their house.
She later found out that a chemical that had been used in the 2001 fracking has been linked to adrenal gland tumors. When she went to Encana, they denied using it on that well or any other. Months later, the Oil and Gas Commission admitted that it had been used after all.
Laura was told her water was safe, but we found out later they never tested it for 2BE. They waited till 4 years after the incident to go back to see if possibly they could find some. That was long gone. She spoke to other people in her neighborhood. She began to see if anybody else was having the kind of health problem she had. And then others began telling me about people they heard about. And I was just amazed at the numbers of people that were involved. And I thought, this is maybe a serious problem. What is going on over there?
After years of mounting medical bills, devalued property, and diminishing options, Laura agreed to a monetary settlement with Encana Corporation, the company responsible for her problems. The settlement stipulated she stopped telling her story publicly, which is why she was not interviewed for this film. Many family stories like hers will never be told because of company settlements that require silence.
An excerpt from the documentary Split Estate by Deborah Anderson. When we come back from break, we'll be joined by a reporter who has been investigating the issue of fracking around the country and the pollution of the nation's water supply. Stay with us. Pollution, Bo Diddley here on Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, The War and Peace Report. I'm Amy Goodman with Juan Gonzalez. We're joined by Abrahm Lustgarten, covers issues around natural gas drilling for ProPublica. Juan?
Well, Abrahm, tell us first, how does this fracking actually work?
It's used to extract oil and gas both very deep underground, in some cases 10,000 feet or 13,000 feet underground. And in the current exploration plays, we're looking at tight sands or shale that hold the gas in tiny little bubbles, and it can't really flow freely. So the oil and gas industry will drill a well, and they'll pump down millions of gallons of liquid, which is sand and water, and then these chemicals that I've been looking at. And they'll pump it down under thousands of pounds of pressure to essentially fracture and break up, obliterate the rock underneath, and let the gas flow back out and come back up to the surface.
And the chemicals that are involved that you say you've been investigating?
Yeah, it's very difficult to know exactly what they are. At this point, the industry has released partial lists. They say that they're mostly complete, but they won't go on the record and say that it represents every single chemical that they've used. In the past, it's included diesel fuel. That's been phased out to rely more on methanol. And then there are a number of soaps and surfactants and lubricants and all sorts of things that they use to essentially engineer the viscosity of the fluid. They want it to go down into the hole as a fairly thick substance, and then you know, on command, they want it to release and get out of the way so the gas can flow right back up past it, and it's chemicals that does all of that.
So in essence, the chemicals then, the residuals then flow into whatever groundwater supply may be in the region, right?
Well, that's what's been very difficult to know. Records are not kept about what amount of fluid and chemicals is taken back out of the well, not in any state where drilling is allowed in the United States. There are geologists who are quite concerned about how far these chemicals and these fluids can travel underground. And then there are these numerous correlative instances of contamination across the country. And until now, it's been very, very difficult to know whether it's the actual fracturing process that's caused this contamination or something else. And it's partially because there's so much secrecy around the fracturing process.
Tell us about the main areas affected in the country.
Well, it's almost everywhere you look where there's drilling. There's drilling in 31 states. Drilling has been happening in Wyoming and Colorado for many years. Probably the most intensive development in the country, at least in the early stages, was there. And that's where you've begun to see quite a bit of problems with the water. And these are largely due to spills sometimes or waste streams that are leaked out into the soil and get into water supplies, and sometimes it's completely mysterious. The documentary clip showed a woman whose well exploded the same day or within a few days of this intensive pressure being pumped into the ground nearby, which implies some kind of geological connection. There have been problems with water in New Mexico, in Wyoming, in Louisiana, in New York,
in
Pennsylvania.
The latest Wyoming EPA study?
In Pavilion, Wyoming, where some of these earliest complaints originated, the EPA has just earlier this year undertaken for the first time a real investigation into what's happening with the water there. They didn't go in to investigate the gas industry or hydraulic fracturing, but it is the first time that they've actually decided that they would test water in response to complaints about water. And they've gone in and tested for the broadest array of pollutants with as much objectivity as they could muster. They've looked for pesticides and agricultural influences and any other influence on the water supply. And EPA folks tell me that they're quite surprised, but what they found in their preliminary